Thank you very much for joining me. Don't forget to like my videos, thumbs them up. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Last night, there was a magnitude 5.2 earthquake. And then at 10:03 p.m. local time, there was a magnitude 5.1. One person said they felt this earthquake, and they were both about 6.2 miles below sea level. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. Yep, eventually down here by Baja, California, it's going to be up there in Santa Barbara and San Francisco. What happened here with these earthquakes was, the rift moved, going north. And there was spreading, making room, widening the Gulf of California. Now, last year, there was a series of earthquakes, but not quite as large as these two. You can see them all marked here. This is from 2021. Example, in fact, December 19th of 2021. It's a misconception that people believe that smaller earthquakes will relieve the pressure, preventing a larger earthquake. That is not true. There was also a 4.8 today, but it started out with the magnitude 5.2. And then the largest one that I have marked here, and not to say that, in fact, it was the largest, but in 2012, there was a magnitude 7.0. Gives you a good indication. This area is capable of having large earthquakes. That 7.0 was on April 7th of 2012. Here we have the data that I downloaded from two different monitors. This is using the Swarm program. You just can't guess about the magnitude of the earthquakes, and sometimes they fudge. Majority of the time they fudge about the earthquakes. And USGS does not often report all the earthquakes that happened down there in the Gulf of California. So I downloaded the information direct from the seismic sites. This one right here was the closest. BC, SFX, and then the other one was AE214A. This one here isn't working. I don't know if I got the wrong data to look for the earthquakes or the wrong number for the seismic station. But this one and this one right here is the monitors that I downloaded from. All right, so here's the two seismic stations. This top one is BC. The bottom one is AC. And you can see that the bottom one, the earthquakes actually came in better, which would be this one right here. Maybe this one hasn't been calibrated recently. I don't know. Yeah, you just can't guess about the size of the earthquakes. You actually gotta go in and get the data and go from there. All right, 4:52, this is the first earthquake. This would be the 5.2 that USGS reported. And you can see the little points. This was tectonic in nature. Yeah, the Gulf of California is slowly moving, spreading, going north. And they did not fudge about this earthquake. It actually comes in as a magnitude 5.23. All right, the next one would be the magnitude 5.1. It actually came in a little bit sooner here at 5:01, not at 5:03. We'll look at the spectrogram. There it is. But that one they were off on. It comes in as a magnitude 5.27. Here you can see we got a smaller one at 5:17 that USGS didn't report. Again, tectonic in nature, movement of the plates, Gulf of California moving north. That one comes in as a magnitude 4.29. And we'll go to the spectrogram. Then we got another one right here. It almost looks like two earthquakes at 8:26. That one comes in as a magnitude 3.29, and they're not reporting it. 9:21, another earthquake, which is not being reported. There's its seismic signature. That one comes in as a 4.11. And we'll go back to the spectrogram. We have another one. It looks like two, actually, at 3:38, almost 25 seconds. We'll go to its signature. This was prior to these other large earthquakes. And that comes in as a magnitude 2.21. It's a small one. You'll notice the sharp points. Actually, you can see the rounded signature better here. Again, that's tectonic. The plate's moving. All right, we got another one here at 8:26. Let me bring it over. It almost looks like two earthquakes. We'll go to the seismic signature. But that comes in as a magnitude 2.75. And then this is what it was showing when I pulled the files just a little while ago. It's about 8 o'clock in the morning, and you can see there's steady movement there in the Gulf of California. Yeah, it's still moving. Boom, 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 as that fault line slowly rips. Yeah, see that? Lots of real small earthquakes. And we'll go to the seismic signature. Yeah, it's hard to tell there. But yeah, you can see it there. Yeah, it's still all rumbling there. And it kind of settled down when I pulled the files. Yeah, right through there. Boom, 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 boom. This is the stream view. This is the actual data that came in on those two monitors. And we'll go back another 4 hours. This is what's currently showing. And right now it's 8:19 a.m. Central Daylight Time. We'll go back another 2 hours, and yeah, you can see these smaller earthquakes. Yeah, we got, oh, it's hard to tell. 1, 2, 3, 4. These are really small. 5 and 6, maybe 7. This one here at 9:09, we'll go to the seismic signature. That comes in as a magnitude 2.81 right there. And then this one at 9:16, that would be universal time. That comes in as a 2.69 also. And we'll look at the spectrogram. Let's pull it over a little bit. I might have made it a little bit too long, meaning where I marked the seismic signature. If I shorten it up, it comes in as a magnitude 2.22. Only one person said they felt the earthquake, and that was actually the 5.1. I'm sure a lot more people did feel this earthquake. But it could be an indication that a larger one is coming. There is going to be smaller quakes coming after this. There's no doubt about that. And it's a poor country. And a lot of people just don't care. They get a lot of earthquakes anyway, so they probably don't send in their reports to USGS unless, of course, it's a magnitude 7 that happened in 2012. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. And as always, please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you.